Hello and welcome to MATLAB course. This is Salim. In this video, I am going to provide an introduction to MATLAB using the following topics. 1. What is machine language? 2. What is programming language and how to convert programming language to machine language? 3. A brief history about MATLAB. 4. Some of MATLAB applications that we can use. Let's start. We use the language to communicate with each other. For example, we can use English to talk to each other, or Japanese, or Arabic, or any other language. But the question is, when you wish to contact or communicate with your computer or machine, which language you are going to use? The machine language is the only language that computers and machine can understand. And machine language, it is binary digits. So if we check here, that the binary digit, it means zeros and ones. For example, if we need to say hello world as a one word to the PC, how to represent that in binary digits? In binary digits, you can see 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. All these number is representing the letter H in the word hello. And then the second group of number is E, and then L, L, O, and then the space. And then the second group of numbers here is the word W, O, R, L, and then D. So it means that every letter represented in numbers from zeros and ones. And suppose that we need to change hello world from the each letter have a the beginning is a small letter to capital letter. What will be the change? Of course, the computer should know the difference between the small letter and the capital letter. So it's already changed here, and the difference between the two sentences in binary file would be the red numbers. So the H small will represent here 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, but in the capital letter it will be 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. So the binary digit, it seems difficult for us as a human to understand. And of course, if you wish to try, like in binary digits, other names or any words, just visit this website and just write the normal word and it will show in binary digits. So, because a binary digit is very difficult to human to write in and also to remember, they invented something called the programming language. And the programming language is allow us as a human, allow us to give some instruction, kind of a command to the computer or machine. So we can ask the computer or ask the machine to do some tasks. But the problem is the computer doesn't understand the programming language. He only understands the machine language. In that sense, we should link between the programming language in which the human can understand to machine language in which the computer can understand. And to convert between the programming language to machine language, we have either way. Some programming language is used compiler. And in the compiler, you wrote many lines of your code. Then this compiler will take the whole code and convert it from the text you wrote to binary digits, which is zeros and one. And then executing this code after that. The other option is using interpreter. And in the interpreter, you write many codes in your programming, but the interpreter will only convert the first line from the text to binary digit and then executing that. And then go to the second line and convert it from text to binary digit, and then executing. So it kind of line by line, it's converting to binary and then executing that line. And the example for the language we're using compiler is C and C++. And example for the language which using the interpreter is MATLAB and Python. And let's discuss about MATLAB history. So MATLAB is a computing environment, so we can use MATLAB to make some estimation and mathematical operation and some calculation and computational things. And also it's a programming language, so you can program by yourself. And MATLAB was invented by Professor Muller in 1970. And in 1984, Masswork Company kind of developed MATLAB and make it commercial so the people can buy and use. And MATLAB is coming from, it's actually two part, and these two parts coming from two words. MATLAB is coming from matrix laboratory. And the matrix, which means array, which means the place to keep and store the data. And this data is mean number. And number could be, for example, only one number, or could be a series of number written in row or written in column. Or it could be 2D numbers, which mean several rows and several columns. Or could be more than that, like three dimension or more, which mean we have several rows, we have several columns, and also we have several layers, like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And each structure, it mean, for example, if we have only one number, we call that scalar. And if we have series of number in row or column, it's called vector. And if we have a group of number in some rows and some columns, it's called matrix. And if it's rows and columns and also layers, it means 3D or more, it's called array, or sometimes people say matrix. And the question is, what is the MATLAB application? MATLAB have a very wide application. The first thing is we can use MATLAB in the calculation and computational things. Like, for example, here we can use similar to the calculator. Or we can use for the neural network to make a very complicated process. And also we can use MATLAB for modeling and simulation. Here, it's showing that this is self-driving cars. And these self-driving cars can detect other car to avoid any collapse or accident. And also we can use MATLAB for data analysis and visualization. So now we are affecting with Corona. And some researchers try to use the data from Corona and they try to do the curve fitting and also prediction what will be the situation in the future. And we can use MATLAB for algorithm development. For example, in this device, this machine, the moving plate is kind of a metal plate. And we have here kind of a camera and we have the lid kind of a source for the light. And then we need to check is the metal surface is flat or there is any bump in that surface. So we can use MATLAB in a very wide application. This is just an introduction, and let's access MATLAB from the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.